हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव कवर्ड ओवोजेनेसिस। एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ ओवोजेनेसिस, एग और ओवम इज फॉर्म्ड। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल स्टडी व्हाट इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ मैच्योर ओवम एंड व्हाट आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ओवा और एग्स। सो मैच्योर ओवम इज स्फेरिकल और ओवल नॉन मोटाइल सेल। इट्स साइज वेरीज बट इट इज ऑलवेज लार्जर देन अदर टाइप्स ऑफ सेल्स। इट अपीयर्स टू बी स्फेरिकल कवर्ड एक्सटर्नली बाय मीन्स ऑफ plasma membrane. When it is fully formed outside plasma membrane, vitelline membrane is formed. The cytoplasm of the egg is known as ovoplasm. The nucleus of the egg, that is female pronucleus, it shifts towards one pole, and it is the pole, that particular pole is known as animal pole. This is actually the pole at which polar bodies they are extruded. If there are two polar bodies, it means ovum is released after second meiotic division. In some animals, ovum is released in secondary oocyte stage. No doubt it appears to be spherical, but actually it shows polarity. What is polarity? Polarity means that the distribution of various cell organelles, it varies around the central axis of the egg. This is the central axis. So this is the animal pole, as I have told you. The pole opposite to the animal pole is the vegetal pole. The axis passing through these two poles, this is the animal vegetal axis. So here just see the distribution of various cell organelles that varies around this central axis. For example, we are studying amphibian ovum. In amphibian ovum, animal half, this particular half contains nucleus, it contains ribosomes, it contains mitochondria, whereas the vegetal half, that is the lower half, it mainly contains yolk. So, distribution of cell organelles and yolk granules, it varies around the animal vegetal axis. At the periphery of the egg, there are present pigment granules and cortical granules. Cortical granules, they are made up of proteolytic enzymes, acid mucopolysaccharides and structural proteins. They mainly help in fertilization. We will study the process of fertilization where these cortical granules, they play an important role. Then, plasma membrane of the egg is raised into very fine processes. These are known as microvilli. So this is the structure of mature ovum. So almost all ova, they show polarity. Polarity is a separate topic. We will study it separately. Then mature unfertilized egg is inert or inactive, because here all cellular mechanisms, they are suspended. Even its messenger RNA is masked. Masked means it is not ready for translation. It can't translate proteins. Only after fertilization, RNA becomes active and protein synthesis starts. So this is the structure of mature ovum. Now we will study what are the different types of eggs. Eggs, they are classified into two categories on the basis of amount of yolk. Ale acetal means without yolk. Example is eutherian mammals. Lacethal means with yolk. Then on the basis of amount of yolk, eggs are classified into three categories: microlacethal or oligolacethal having small amount of yolk, example is Hardmania. Mesolacethal means moderate amount of yolk, then medium amount of yolk. Macrolacethal or polylacethal having large amount of yolk, example is reptiles and birds. So this is on the basis of amount of yolk. Second classification is on the basis of distribution of yolk. So naturally here we are taking lacethal eggs, which are classified into two categories: homo or isolacethal, in which yolk is uniformly distributed throughout the ovoplasm, example is echinoderms and annelids; heterolacethal or anisolacethal, in which yolk is more concentrated at particular points. So heterolacethal eggs, they are further of three types: telolacethal, in which yolk is more concentrated towards one pole, as we have studied in amphibian egg; then myolacethal, in which whole of the egg is filled with yolk, leaving behind a small disc-like area of active cytoplasm. So, sirf enne hisse de vich cytoplasm hunda, baki sare da sara egg jehda, that is filled with yolk. It means this egg is macrolacethal, it contains large amount of yolk, and it is myolacethal because yolk fills whole of the ovoplasm, leaving behind a small disc-like area known as blastodisc. Example is reptiles and birds. Third type of egg is centrolacethal. In centrolacethal type of egg, whole of the yolk is that fills the egg, leaving behind a thin layer of peripheral cytoplasm. This green one is peripheral cytoplasm. So this example is insect egg. Insect egg is also covered by shell. So for the entry of sperm, there is a small opening known as micropyle. So this is central acetyl egg. Now you have to classify these eggs on the basis of amount of yolk as well as on the basis of distribution of yolk. It may be asked under question number 1. Now what type of frog's egg is? Frog's egg is, what type of egg is? It is mesolacetyl because it contains moderate amount of yolk, and it is telolacetyl because yolk is concentrated towards one pole. Then regarding birds or reptiles or bird's egg, this egg is macrolacetyl because it contains large amount of yolk, and it is meiolacetyl because yolk fills whole of the ovoplasm, leaving behind a disc-like area. What type of insect egg is? It is macrolacetyl as well as it is centrolacetyl. It contains large amount of yolk. Yolk fills whole of the ovoplasm, leaving behind thin peripheral layer of cytoplasm. So you may be asked them under question number 1. So this is a very simple topic related to different types of eggs and what is the structure of mature ovum. If you will have any doubt, we will clear in the Google Meet.